Hi everyone, it's Susan from Vintage Jewelry Supplies Company. Today I'm hoping that I'll be able to share some tips with you to make our website a little bit easier to use. We got this new website in January and some of you have told me that it's a little bit confusing and a lot going on. So maybe if I share some tips with you that help me to navigate it occasionally, then might help you too. We have more than 4,600 items now, so that's a lot of information to sift through every time you sign in and shop. So in order to make it a little bit easier to break it down, you can go down to our information section and click on sitemap. And that gives you every single page on the website at a glance if you don't want to work with all those drop-down menus that come under the banners on the left-hand side. So everything you need to know is there, broken down in simple form. You can just click on it and go to whatever section you're looking for. It's a little bit easier for some people that way. Now, the first thing you should do when you go to the website, of course, is to sign in. I have signed in as myself, and now I'm going to go to my account. All of the things that have to do with you, the addresses you've got saved, your personal information, never your payment information. Your payment information is never saved. You have to enter that fresh each time, and the cookie only lasts for long enough for the transaction to be completed. So you never have to worry about anything important being lost or being misplaced because we don't save it. Your history of your past orders is something that you might need to know. You can go back and see all of the information from a past order. I've made several attempts to do something over the years to test something. So you can see, you know, your order number and click on it and go back and see what you were going to buy that day, the item that was on that list. If that can help you to recover, you know, what you're looking for, maybe that would work. Another thing that you might need to know about is when you're getting ready to shop, you go to an item that you're interested in and you want to add it to your cart. And you think, oh, I'll get that the next time I'm there. I'm not going to get that today. Then don't put it in your cart. Put it down here to your wish list. The cart is only for the things that you want to buy today. The site doesn't save that information after you sign out. But if you're signed in and you want to save something for another day, put it in your wish list. Go down to the wish list category on the side and click on it. You can create several wish lists. And I'll show you why that's important. Let's do one for beads. So we've got another one now that says beads. So we've got beads, findings, stones. So you can break it down even further when you're shopping. If you put something in your cart and you just want to look at the beads that you're interested for next time, you can go to Check Class Beads and pick out the one that you like. Let's say you're interested in this Alexandrite bell. Go down to the wish list again and bring up beads in the drop-down menu. The next item you save to your wish list is going to go on that particular wish list. So when I go back to the wish list and go to beads, that stone, that bead is now there. So that will help you organize the things that you buy normally and help you keep up with what you want to buy the next time. And it won't be all in one category. So that's something to remember. You can use that wish list to make your own catalog to narrow down your searches for next time. So let's see, we've the wish list right there. I want to make sure you saw that. You can sign up for the newsletter, put your email in, and click OK. And we send an email out, a newsletter email about once a month. And I try to include some tips that might be helpful to you, some design tips. And there's never a charge for those. We just send those out to be helpful and, you know, share a little bit of new information for you. Another thing I wanted to talk to you about is we now have this... If something's out of stock, there's a little block that says notify me when this item is back in stock. We have 4,600 and something items now, and I think we're only out of maybe 19 of them. That's pretty good. I'm just going to try to find something to show you this. Okay. Notify me when available. So you're signed in. All you have to do is click that, and you'll get an email. If that item is out of stock, you'll get an email when it's back in. This one we have 440 orders in stock. So if you're ever wondering, gee, I need to order a lot. I wonder how many she has. Yes, you can see exactly how many we have in stock. If you just click on the full description, sometimes when people go to, you know, you just click on the category and you see, oh, okay, there's a lot of things on there. And if you click on this, you'll see the items broken down. This little, there's a scale, a little graph here. And if you click on that one, you can shop by item, by picture, and the full description rather than just pictures of all of them. Or if you want to see just all the pictures of what we have, you can click on the other one and see all the products we have within that category, page after page after page. And if you go down here to the bottom, you can click 50 items and you can see 50 items at one time rather than just 20. That doesn't last throughout your whole visit though. You have to, when you change to a different category, you have to go down and adjust that little drop-down menu again. So that helps you to see more items at one time. I was hoping I would come across one of these. Occasionally we add a picture that shows you the item that you're looking at used in a finished piece, or at least a piece that's been started. I'm hoping to add a lot more of these pictures over the year, the next coming months, or over this coming year. I do have to sit down and create that piece. No one on my staff is a jewelry designer. They are very diligent, and they try to pack your orders very well and make sure there's no mistakes made, but no one is actually a jewelry designer. So it's me who has to sit down and do all that, and I'm pretty busy right now, so that kind of makes it a little difficult to take the time to do all the things I want to do for you. But we do try to show you how it looks used in a piece, in a finished piece. This banner that comes in the long description shows you 30 other products that are in that same category, and sometimes you can click through that and quickly find what you're looking for. Let's say, for instance, that you only are interested in, jump rings. And while we're talking about jump rings should always be used when you connect a pendant or a strand of beads. It allows your strand to move freely. A lot of people tell me that they try to connect the strand directly to the finding, be it an earring finding or, you know, a connector, whatever. If you just hook your head pin or eye pin directly into the loop of the connector, it will always get hung up. It won't hang freely, but the jump ring will help it have plenty of movement, and it will always hang straight and be nice. So there's my jewelry making tip for the day. But if you notice, I clicked jump rings. I entered jump rings here in the search window, and all of our jump rings, every word, every description that has jump rings in its title or in the description will come up when you do a search that way. We have quite a few jump rings, so that'll give you a tip. If you want a certain thing, let's say, maybe this one, and you want to know if I have that in any other color, just pick out the first three words and pull it up there to the drop-down menu. Highlight it, pull it up to the search window, and everything that has those search words in the first part will come up, and you can see that we have that in oxidized brass, we have it in oxidized silver, and we have it in bright gold. We do have a few customers who ask for bright finishes, so we have started getting a few more of those pieces, but we don't have too many at this time. As you can see, the richness of the oxidized metal shows all the details so well. The piece just, all the peaks and valleys show up. The details are so rich. The pieces like this particular piece, which is quite Victorian, just look a lot richer and more interesting when they have that antiquing in the recesses. So hopefully I've shared some things with you today that helped you for your next visit, and maybe you can go down to your wish list when you're ready to make your purchase And you can find right away what you're looking for because it'll be narrowed down into your specialized search. So use the wish list like your own personal catalog to make your shopping a little bit easier. And as always, if you ever have a problem with signing in or paying for your order, or if you can't find what you're looking for, anytime you come across a problem, you can email me at AccessoriesSusan@AOL.com, which is the same email address I've had for the last 13 years. And I keep that one because you can send pictures or links or attachments or whatever. And if you need me to look for something for you, that's the email address you can use to reach me personally. You can write to me at Susan@VintageJewelrySupplies.com. And Regina and Cindy and I are always checking that all day long. So if somebody needs help, we try to get back to you immediately. And if they see that it's a design question and I need to answer it right away, then they'll forward it to me and hopefully I can get back to you within a few hours with an answer. We always try to give you the best help that is available and to serve your needs and ship your order right away. I hope you have a great fall season. Some of you are writing to say that you're having great shows and a lot of success. I'm very happy for you. That's great. So have a good holiday season and enjoy designing and creating and selling your creations. And feel free to share pictures with us at any time. We'd love to hear from you. We'd love to visit with you on Facebook. So come and visit us there as well. There's a link right here, so let's go to Facebook, and I'll see you there. I'm about to load this video on. Thanks. Bye.